Sunday school teachers here at Grace, our parents, our grandparents, all and we offer a little prayer together. We laid our hands on them, and of course, I'm sure that they invited you to come up and join them for that. They'll each come up individually. So what we do is we pray in Jesus' name to stir up the work of the Holy Spirit. So we give thanks for the stirring of the Holy Spirit that has gotten these five guys to this place. But also we look forward to the stirring of the Holy Spirit as God continues to work in their lives and as God continues to call them into greatness and to do great things in the church and in the communities and wherever you five guys will find yourselves in the coming years. So we celebrate with you today. We celebrate with your families. We just make a few announcements before we begin. I want to give thanks for our E30 radio sponsor. That was in honor of Noah Borsted's baptismal anniversary on October 25th from Tim and Ann Borsted. And then the bulletin that you hold in your hand are in honor of Brayton's confirmation from his grandparents, Dave and Deb Lewis. So thank you for those gifts. Want to let you know, at least the community, that on Wednesday we'll be heading out. The youth of our congregation will be heading out, which we call the trick-or-treating for the local food shed. And so if you can be home at 5, between 5 and 6, that's great. If not, if you can have your items that you're willing to donate to the food shelf ready and kind of in a visible location in town, we'll be canvassing the whole town. So that takes a little while, and if you can have those items ready for you, ready for them when they come, that would be great. We're trying to collect 500 items on Wednesday. I mean, hope we collect more, but if we collect 500 items, then we'll get an additional $500 for the work of our food shelf. So that's a great incentive, and maybe that'll spur some generosity for members of our community. I just want to remind you of our 50-plus potluck that's coming up on October 30th. And then also, for the women of the church, we have the Wealth of Fall Retreat. They have a dinner theater that's going to Green Lake Lutheran Bible Camp. And so registrations are coming up. We put some information in the bulletin, but just if you can be mindful of that, that will be helpful as well. So, again, welcome to Grace, and welcome to our conference and the work that you've done to help with this service together. We're going to turn now to and present the confirmation class, and so as I call your name, then you would stand and then just turn to the congregation. So, dear friends, we give thanks for the gift of baptism and for the people who are with us in the body of Christ who are making public affirmation of their baptism. Let us join together in prayer. Merciful God, we thank you for these brothers and sisters whom you have made your own by water and the word of baptism. You called them to yourself. You've enlightened them with the gifts of your Spirit and nourished them in the community of faith. Uphold your servants in the gifts and promises of baptism and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ. Amen. So in response to the love of God, together with instruction in the Christian faith, these young men, before you, wish to publicly affirm their baptismal promises. Cody Stephen Johnson. Grant Donald Martinson. Sawyer Lee Plesner. Braden John Wenninger. And Jesse James Wilson. And let's offer our congregational response together. The words are on the screen and we are also in your bulletins. We rejoice in your desire to make public profession of your faith and assume greater responsibility in the life of the Christian community and its mission in the world. So, conference, I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, to reject sin and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? If so, then say, I renounce them. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? If so, say, I renounce them. And do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? And then I'll ask the congregation to stand as we're led by confess our common faith together using the words of our Apostles' Creed. So I'll ask you, do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into heaven. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. And do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And the congregation may be seated. So with your fellow brothers and sisters of Christ, and you've made public profession of your faith, and so I'll ask you, do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you? Baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ in word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth. Cody? Grant? Sawyer? Braden? Jesse,
let us confess our sin in the presence of God. came into the world that we might have life. This is what love is. It is not that we have loved God, but that God loves us and sent Jesus to be the means by which our sins are forgiven. Therefore, by his authority, I declare unto you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Always upon your spirit. Lord Almighty, may you be the God of hope, the Lord of God.
came into the district of Caesarea Philippi. He asked his disciples, "Who do you people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say that John the Baptist, but others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and every bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
they talk a portion of their faith statements with us. They all have a kind of late night FM radio voices, don't they? I can listen to them all night long. So thank you for sharing your confirmation verse with us. We're going to invite now them up individually to lay our hands on them and offer that prayer blessing. So if you've been invited to join the confirmation, we're going to have Cody come up first. Cody's family. Thank you. faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and bring him to everlasting life. Amen. And let us rejoice with Braden, our brother in Christ. We rejoice with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all the world.
Thank you.
congregation will rise.
Let us pray. Merciful God, everything in heaven and earth belongs to you. We joyfully release what you have entrusted to us. May these gifts be signs of our whole life return to you, dedicated to the healing and unity of all creation. Through Jesus Christ. Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
And so we remember together in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, lead us into your kingdom and teach us all as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Congregation, may be
seated. Thank you. and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. O God, we give you thanks that you have set before us in this feast the body and the blood of our Son. By our Spirit, strengthen us to serve all in need, to give ourselves away